Neil Hinch, been a crane operator for 31 years. Worked for Belcher Target Service out of Wichita, Kansas, about 5.5 years. And I've ran about all types of cranes, different brands and of all different styles. Hydraulic and lattice boom being my favorite. We're in the Port of Catoosa, east of Tulsa, Oklahoma, at Terra Nitrogen doing a heater rebuild. We've been taking parts of this heater apart, took the convection box off the top, the coil bundles, tube coil bundles out of the heater. Now we have 157 feet of long-range boom in the crane with ABC upper, AB lower counterweights on, and 165-ton block of 6 parts of line. We've had the luffing jib in it 2 different times. Most recent was on a job we had max boom in it, 236 feet of main boom and 236-foot luffing jib. And, made a 42,000-pound pick with it at 130-foot radius. And the operation of the crane was extremely nice, very smooth. Every aspect of it handles nice. And we have had the wind tip on it. We haven't actually got to use it yet out on a wind farm, but we had it assembled at our yard, and we did make some picks with it, and I think that's going to be a pretty handy tool, you know, when we work on a wind farm. Yeah, it's you know, the winch is in the base section. It's a little different, you know. You definitely need to rely on the cameras that are mounted in there to, you know, make sure the reading's right on the drums. And but I kind of like them up there. The block, it's a pretty nice setup. You know, you just simply slip the outer shoulders on it, shove the big pin through it, you know, now you got a 350-ton block. Pull one pin and pull the shoulders off, and then you got a 165-ton block. Crane is exceptionally smooth operation. It has a great feel to it. The controls are, you know, extremely smooth. The cab is extremely quiet. Very nice machine. Very nice machine. Yeah, the ergonomics, you know, in the cab are, you know, as good as I've seen in a crane. I mean, it's basically like sitting in your recliner in your front room playing a video game. I use the tilt cab when you know, we have a lot of boom and working up high. It definitely makes it easier on your net, not having to sit there, you know, bent back all day. On the heavier pigs, you can turn the winch speed down on it, 5 meter it down, and you know, you can, if they want a hair, you can give it to them in colors. That precise. Yeah, the computer is really, for as big of a crane as it is and as many attachments as it has, it's pretty user friendly. It's not complicated at all to use. It's pretty self-explanatory. And the readout on it, as far as when you're in, you know, crane operation, gives you a lot of important data. So it's all right there at the, you know, turn of the head. You've got a hook height and radius, boom angle. We traveled on the machine. We had it out on a wind farm and had to take it across, you know, some wheat fields. And, you know, the crane makes a really light footprint walking. There's been a lot of these types of cranes turned over, these bigger cranes turned over out on the wind farms. And this was really makes a light footprint walking across there. And, you know, the travel is fast compared to some of the others, and it really travels well. Walking with the load, you know, if you need just fractions of an inch, you can ease it in, and, well, I mean, you can give them a fraction of an inch. One of the things that impressed me about the crane, not knowing, you know, being a new machine, was cutting it around. A lot of these, you know, these heavier cranes don't want to cut very well. And, you know, with the quad drive on the tracks on this, you can take one forward, one backward, and it never slows down. It cut right around, just like you need to. I have an older to handle the daily maintenance. The tracks have automatic greasers on them, so it's just as simple as keeping the grease pots full, and it does the rest. It greases all the hydras and rollers and everything, and the swing bearing is on an automatic grease pot as well, so it's just a matter of keeping it full. Everything else, with the exception of the shivs and the head section, can be greased from down on at ground level on the machine. So it makes it nice. You know, in the past, some cranes you either had to climb up there to do it or lay the thing down. You know, so they were kind enough to give us ways to grease it without having to do all that. You know, assembly and disassembly is really nice on it. It's probably one of the easiest cranes that I've put together and tore apart. It goes together easy and fast, and same way on disassembly. You know, counterweight installation is easy on it. The upper weight does require the use of an assist crane, which, you know, it's no problem. I mean, but you know, it's fast. Most of the time we're waiting on trucks to get in with our counterweights to put them on. I like that. Undecking the crane, they have the new pinning system on there. I've worked around others that, you know, require quite a bit of work, you know, to get the thing, you know, pinned to the house, pinned to the car body. And this, simply set it down on there with the flip of the switch, it shoves all the pins out, come back, put the safety latches on, and you're done. It takes a total of about 10 minutes. So hauling all the counterweight, all the crane pieces, and putting max boom in it was 27 truckloads, two truckloads of mats. So with the right crew, with our usual crew that stays with it, we could start at, say, 7 o'clock in the morning, get the house unloaded off the trailer, have the car body on it, car body weights, the tracks, the upper tray, and the base section in it by noon, ready to stab boom in after lunch. It's an extremely nice crane. Matter of fact, it's definitely became my favorite crane to operate. And believe it or not, you won't hear a lot of operators say this, but really half the fun's putting the thing together and tearing it apart.